this Florida Derby day, remember to sign up with DRF Bets.
Dan Illman, Mike Buehr, let's kick off a 50-cent late pick five at Gulfstream Park. The final leg is the Florida Derby. The first leg, this race, will throw up the field for the Grade II Pan American Stakes. It is race number 10, and we're going a mile and a half on the turf. And you see an old war horse is your morning line favorite. That's the 3. Saddler's Joy has banked $2.6 million in his career. He won the Pan American in 2017. He's the kind of horse that needs pace, Mike, and I don't see any speed in here.
Yeah, it's always a concern with Saddler's Joy, man. You know where he's going to be early, and that's going to be at the back of the pack. Really, really good horse. He's 8 years old now. Seems like he can still run, Dan. We'll see if he works out a trip.
Now, we throw up the Timeform U.S. pace projector. You'll notice no blue bar. They think this pace will be run at an honest tempo. I just don't see any speed. Churn and Burn can stay up close to the pace. I guess he's the most likely pace setter. I guess the good news about Cross Border is he's a very versatile horse that can work out his trip. But boy, your deep closer is Saddler's Joy, the number 3, along with the number 4, Reheka. They're going to need some help.
Yeah, they're going to need something to happen up front here to give them their best chance. Saddler's Joy's overcome disadvantageous pacing errors in the past. I don't know if he's capable of that anymore. So we'll see what happens with him. Cross Border, I just feel like they're going to go forward with him in here, Dan. He's very capable of that.
New York bred Cross Border has earned over $750,000. Let's watch his third place effort in the Pegasus World Cup. I thought that the jock did the right thing here, Mike. He could have went to the far outside on the turn. He decided to stay in, and everything works out. He's eventually going to split horses and get up for third behind Colonel Liam, one of the best turf horses in the country. Colonel Liam came out of this race to win the Muniz at the Fairgrounds last week with a 99 buyer. Cross Border was firing at the end.
Yeah, very game to get up for third. I agree with you that Gaffalione probably did the right thing and gave him every chance in there. He was game to get third. He was entered in that Muniz last weekend. They elected to not take on Colonel Liam again, and they ran him here. And I can't argue with the decision, Dan. I mean, I think they found a really good spot for him.
Cross Border is trained by Michael Maker, as is the number 2, Temple, another horse that likes to nibble. Second in the McKnight, fourth in the McDermott. He's an honest horse, and again, his tactical speed will allow him to work out good trips. The question is he good enough and tough enough to win a race like this?
Yeah, that's the question that I had too. And it's not like he's going to be some kind of great price in here that you won't be able to resist. He will get a good trip. He's very tactical. He's handy. He can sit up close to the pace. But at the end of the day, he's really had his chances in his last 2 starts and just wasn't quite good enough.
Here's the venerable 8-year-old Saddler's Joy, 4th in the McKnight last time out, his first start this year. I thought last year he showed he could run in several races. I thought he was in some traffic in the Red Smith 2 starts back and he ran, but he's always at the mercy of race and pace luck. And it really depends what kind of price he's going to be. If he's your 5-2 favorite, I might want to take a slight swing against him.
Yeah, I look at it in the same way. I'm not going to be surprised when he wins. In a lot of ways, I'm hoping that he wins a race like this because he's a horse who hasn't gotten to the winner's circle in a long time, but he can still run. He's just the kind of horse, it's always way more fun to bet Saddler's Joy when he's a price than when he's a short one.
Reheka was grade 3 placed as a 2-year-old in Southern California. It hasn't really panned out for him. Let's watch his last race, going a mile and a half at Gulfstream. This is a $25,000 starter allowance, a far cry from the graded stakes horses he'll be facing on Saturday. He gives a good account. He's going to finish second in here. He's going to have to do a lot better. And with his running style, you can argue, well, if he and Saddler's Joy start in the same place, you'd rather have Saddler's Joy.
Correct. This horse has run fine in each of his last 3 starts going long, but it doesn't make me want to bet him against this field.
The 5, Angelus Warrior, is a stakes-placed horse at Canterbury. Another horse just doesn't have a lot of speed. They're going to try to stretch him out in distance, and maybe that'll work for him, but he got a pace last time out and just really didn't do much in the stretch at a big price.
Right. Didn't like his race last time. He doesn't really have that one line on his page that you can point to and feel like he's going to be competitive in here.
And Sir Sahib is Temple-like in that he's usually right there at the wire in his good races, at least, but he just rarely wins. He hasn't won in almost 2 years. His McDermott, it was okay, but it was a race where he was likely pace compromised a bit. He's another one that just doesn't have speed. I'm a fan of this horse. I'm just not sure where the setup is coming from.
Yeah, that is the real concern with him, because he was certainly compromised last time, taken back off the pace. They didn't go fast in front of him. He actually ran pretty well. And it was a nice bounce back effort off of a disappointing run one start before that. This horse is pretty good, Dan, and he might be a fair price in here.
Moon Over Miami just looks like he's coming into the race the right way for the powerhouse combination, Bill Mott, Junior Alvarado. Let's watch his McDermott. This was a race, remember, where Phantom Currency and Tide of the Sea basically ran 1-2 all the way around the track. Moon Over Miami is going to try to rally into it, and he had to alter course very sharply off of Temple's Heels in mid-stretch. And listen, if he runs fourth or fifth in here, you're fine with it, but he continues to grind and grind, and he is finding his best stride at the very end of this race. He also is not just some one-paced plotter. He can make his trip. I think Alvarado, who is a fantastic turf rider, is going to have him close.
Yeah, I agree with you. Listen, I liked him a lot last time and bet him in that race. And when I watched it live, I felt like maybe he got a little unlucky there. Just watching the replay back, it's hard not to think that he wasn't going to be a lot closer in that race. Not only did he have the trouble in the stretch where he had to alter, Dan, but even all the way around that final turn, Alvarado just couldn't get him clear to get any momentum built up. And I think it really cost his horse at the end.
Churn and Burn is interesting for this reason. He was always an okay horse, and they stretched him out for the first time last time out, and he became maybe a little bit better than okay. Let's watch this race. I know it's only an entry-level allowance on February the 11th, but it was his first time going a mile and a half, and he did show that tactical speed. He takes over the lead, and he is off to the races. By far his best buyer speed figure of 88, he might be able to get a nice, easy trip on the lead. This is a huge step up in class, but maybe this horse has just found what he's been waiting for, and that is a long distance of ground on turf.
Yeah, I agree. I don't love the field that he beat last time, but it's hard not to notice that he took a big step forward in there, Dan, and he's got the right running style for this race.
Top pick time for the Grade 2 Pan American Stakes. Our hearts with Sadler's Joy. We're big fans. Think he might be a little bit too short on the tote. We have the same exact, a different order. 7-1 for Mike, 1-7 for me. Moon Over Miami is way more progressive than Cross Border.
That's why I like him, Dan. I got to give him one more chance. I feel like he might have been best last time and got very unlucky.
7-1-3-2 for Mike, 1-7-2-8 for me. It's the Grade 2 Pan American Stakes, kicking off a 50-cent late pick 5 at Gulfstream Park on Florida Derby Saturday. Good luck.